वेलकम टू 1 वीक IST अप्रूव्ड ऑनलाइन STDP ऑन डिजिटल कंटेंट डेवलपमेंट फॉर इफेक्टिव एंड इफिशिएंट टीचिंग। माय नेम इज तनुज रोहनकर एंड आई एम गोइंग टू कंडक्ट द फर्स्ट सेशन ऑफ Day 5 ऑन गूगल क्लासरूम। इन दिस पैंडमिक आई होप यू आर डूइंग वेल एंड सेफ। एट दिस पर्टिकुलर टाइम व्हेन रेगुलर क्लासेस हैज बीन सस्पेंडेड, we need to resolve to a solution, and online classes must be one such solution. We must adhering to some of the other ways and must be using online classes. In this STDP, we go through a various softwares and tools that you can readily use in your teaching learning experience. Now, first tool I will be taking up is Google Classroom. It is a product offered by Google that can be served as a replica of a virtual classroom or real classroom which is physically present. As a teacher, when we enter a classroom, we have some course material to provide to students, and also we take their assessment through their assignment, quizzes, questionnaires and various other format. We also grade them regularly. It is a structured tool to help teacher to manage a coursework. It also enhances communication and collaboration. Next, we will see the salient features of Google Classroom. The first feature, that is, facilitates organization of a course content in a digital form. It supports assessments through assignments and quiz. Definitely, it is a free of cost. Here, we can teach together, means 20 instructors at the same time can join the same class. Student progress can be tracked. Discussion forum is present. With the help of this, the communication will be enhanced. Here, we are able to maintain a great book of students. Now let us start building a classroom for your own course. Here I will be telling you how to set your Google Classroom account and to create your first Google class. For that, you need to log in to your Gmail account first. Then open a tab and type URL, that is classroom.google.com. Please remember this URL, classroom.google.com. Once you enter this URL, the basic layout related with the Google Classroom will appear. Various options are given. First option is plus button. This plus button provides you two basic operations. First is the join class, which is related with your students. Second is a create class, which we will be used in next. Then here we have a mandatory set of apps that provided by Gmail. A Google Drive is over here to store your data. A set of classes is visualized that once you create a several classes. First thing I will be showing is join class option. When you do join class, this is for students, it asks you for a class code. Now, once you create a class, you will be getting a class code that you can share with your students, and students join this class by using class code. As of now, we have not created any class, so no class code to share. We are going to create our first Google class. For that, you have to click on the plus button. Then we have an option for the create class. Remember that this is the first step that you have to take to create your Google class. Then terms and condition, click over here and say continue. After that, one window will appear with several fields. First field is the class name. As I am teaching to third year students, so my class name is BE third year IT. Then pass the section name, that is TEITB. Then subject name, as I am teaching theory of computation as a subject, then pass the room number if there any. Then click on the create button. Remember that section, subject and room number are the optional field, but class name is mandatory. So click on the create button. It will create your first Google classroom. It will take some time to create your Google classroom. This is the basic layout of your classroom. Most important thing over here is your class code, which I talked about earlier. If you click over here, you are able to display your class code. This is the code you have to remember and you have to share with your students, because through this they are able to join this class. Now I recommend to resume these steps and create your own Google classroom. In next lecture, I am going to talk about Stream tab, Classwork tab, People tab, Grade tab. Stay tuned. Thank you.